we buy some, for the rice ball, you can call it the Chinese-style dumpling.
Naijun Wong is packing up another delivery of groceries and necessities, hand sanitizer and masks. In the last 2 weeks, he's delivered about a dozen packages to people who are self-quarantined after arriving back home in Ontario from China.
We focus on teamwork, right? And if one person needs help, as a, you know, Canadian, and it's my duty to help them.
As a member of the community, I just want to contribute to something. Also, I want to set an example for my son.
Volunteers say there are hundreds across Ontario ready to help complete strangers with anything, from grocery shopping and running errands to delivering vehicles at the airport. Those who are self-quarantined say even though they aren't sick and weren't near the coronavirus epicenter, they're being extra cautious to protect others.
This is sensible and responsible action for my own family, for the co-workers, and for the societies. And I think this is the right thing to do.
Lyndon, Markham, Mississauga.
Volunteers created groups on WeChat based on areas. Those who are self-quarantined can join the group, request what they need, and post their address. A volunteer responds based on location, picks up, and delivers the items. The bill is paid through e-transfer, and volunteers don't charge a cent more. They leave the bags outside the house, take a photo, and alert the person inside. There's never face-to-face contact.
To support each other, and then I think we will win the battle with the virus.
The volunteers say they'll continue making deliveries as long as needed, saying if people continue to take extra precautions to keep other people safe, they'll keep helping them to make that possible. Angelina King, CBC News, Mississauga.